us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
What did it work?
Yeah.
Just one word from the Lord.
Listen, we need some new scriptures.
We'll move all the doubt.
It takes.
And cause a sun.
It takes knowledge. It takes knowledge.
And give us peace.
To know what God or anything, how to do something. It takes knowledge. Let me give you my definition of wisdom. And then I'm going to give you my definition of stupidity and ignorance.
Come on now.
Reverend, we ain't going back. He done called us stupid.
No, you apply whatever you need to apply. Mm-hmm. Wisdom is the proper application of knowledge.
Well.
Wisdom is the proper, that's very simple, the proper application of knowledge. Now, I've said that I can take this scripture and I can turn this scripture and twist this scripture and try to make it fit me in it any way I want to. I can go out there and bootleg the Bible. Anything. Hey, I go out there and, excuse me, like kids say, I can go out there and pimp the Bible.
That was rude.
Just to make me a dollar.
Well,
you can do it. But when you have the proper application of the scripture, you'll apply it the way that God intended.
Well,
now, let's talk about ignorance. Ignorance is the lack of knowledge. Can we agree on that?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
We can agree on that, huh? All right. Ignorance is the lack of knowledge. Open that door because I might have to run on this one. Now let's talk about stupidity. Stupidity is knowing the thing not to do and avoid the thing not to do, or knowing the thing to do and refusing to do it. That's stupidity.
That's right.
Oh, my Lord. I'm not in the house anymore. You have a choice.
All right.
We can choose to be ignorant and not read the Bible and find out what God wants us to do. That's your choice.
Yeah.
We can choose to hear what God's word say. We can choose to know what we have, a knowledge of the word, and refuse it and be stupid.
Yes, yes.
We can choose to do that. That's your choice.
Yes.
But however you choose, understand that there's no man that's going to call you in on the carpet about it, but eternity will show up. And it will. Eternity, Alpha and Omega, you know eternity? Eternity will require that you respond to what he has given you. No man will be held faultless if he has heard the gospel of Jesus Christ. Every man, and the Bible tells us when the word has been preached to the uttermost parts of the world, then shall the end come. It says when. That word indicates that it's not an if, it's a when. That it will happen.
Yes.
That the gospel will go to every creature on this earth. They will have heard about Jesus Christ. But if it's their choice, then they're going to be held accountable. In eternity.
Yes.
I have put my word in your mouth and covered you with the shadow, the supervision of my hands. Lord, look here. Then, Psalms 25 and 12 said, who then is the man that fears the Lord? God will instruct him in the way he has chosen.
Well.
Listen, God got this deck stacked. He's got it stacked. He's telling every scripture that I run across. He's saying, I'm going to do for you, and I'm going to let you know I'm going to help you to do what I'm telling you to do.
Wow.
I'm going to teach you. I'm going to train you. I'm going to show you how you need to do it. Right. Don't worry about it. All you got to do is be available, be open, right, be receptive, right, to what I'm saying to you.
Yes, wow. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The reception part, when you receive him, when you receive his word, believe me, God works that thing in your life.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to have anybody come and tell you how bad you live.
That's right.
Because God will tell you. And you know what? God won't tell you like we tell you. God is a loving and merciful God, but he's a just and righteous God as well.
Yeah.
See, we may get all indignant and everything and so on and so forth, but God will come to you. He'll lay it before you. He'll make this, listen, he'll make this proposal. He'll lay it out. You say, I'll make an offer you can't refuse.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. All right.
And then he leaves it in your hand.
Yes, yes, yes.
But me, I'm going to tell you, hey, man, I told you the other day, da-da-da-da. I'm going to see you next week and doing the same thing. I say, you don't believe what I told you the other day, you know? Then I come back, and after a while, I might get frustrated at telling you about what you're doing. You need to change.
Well, right.
But God is never frustrated.
That's right.
Thank you.
God is never stirred.
Thank you.
Yeah.
He's never, ever upset about what you do. He loves you. But he hates sin.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are. I had a hard time, and I'm going to tell you point blank. I had a hard time ministering to homosexuals. I had a hard time ministering. And God literally set me down. And we had a conversation. He asked me, basically, do you minister to thieves? I said, yeah, I minister to thieves. You minister to the little gangsters on the corner. Yeah, I minister to them. You minister to murderers, child abusers, adulterers, wife abusers. Yeah, I minister to them.
Yeah.
You on it, man.
All sin is sin. And what you have done is sin.
Well.
So now I'm standing in sin trying to judge somebody about their sin.
Well.
You think I'm going to stand in that?
No.
Oh, Lord. I said, Lord, forgive me, cleanse me, help me to minister to everybody the way I ought to minister to. God put the word in my mind to give to everybody, and I said, I ain't going to give it to you.
Help us.
Are you doing anybody like that? Have you ever told anybody that they're not worth your time? They not worth your breath? Come on now. Do you see how simply the adversary can deceive us?
Yeah.
That's his job.
Yes, sir.
I said it before, and he does it where? He wants to destroy you. He wants to change you. He wants to alter what you believe about God and Christ.
Yeah.
And he wants you to go contrary from what God has put in your mind.
Yeah. You're right.
He wants you to lose it. He wants you to get upset. I'm going to lay my religion down. He wants you to get to that point. But you know, every time I get to that point, I think, I ain't got nothing in this world.
Now the calm on the sea, but what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.